What is good, YouTube? It is Bree Hall, aka Lahara, aka Smartista Beauty for my OGs, and welcome back to my channel. Now, for those of you who've been following me for a really long time, you know my afro has been every color under the sun, moon, and rainbow. I love changing up my hair color and my hairstyles, but sometimes that can cause damage because I do it so excessively. So I have found that the best option sometimes when I want a quick, unique hair color is to do it on wigs. Today, I'm going to be customizing this wig. So I was sitting at home daydreaming about cotton candy and I was like, what if I did a cotton candy inspired wig? So that's what I'm doing today. I'm so shy, yeah. I'm just sectioning this hair. So I took a little bit of conditioner I had just sitting around the house and I mixed 6 bowls of unique colors. I even decided to throw a little orange in there. The conditioner dilutes the colors to make them a little bit more pastel, which is what we're going for. And I went in and applied the colors by hand at first. And then once I got to the top sections towards the front where I wanted it to be a little bit more precise, I went in with a dye brush. But as you can see, I put darker colors towards the roots and I really just had fun. I didn't really get too precise with applying plastic. I just kind of wung it, if I will be honest. But I really love how it came out, and this is how it looks wet after all of the color is applied. And I'll list the colors I use in the description box. Today's video is sponsored in partnership with Dyson Hair, and I'm going in with my air wrap that I got last year. It's still in such great condition, and I'm just going in with the brush attachment and blow drying the hair just to get some of the excess moisture out of it. Since I am a night owl, I love coloring my units at night, and then I let it sit in a microfiber towel. This saves me a lot of time styling the following day. And this also helps because it preps the hair for styling later and gets all the tangles out. You know, my favorite part about having bright colors, even when I had it on my real hair, is that when your hair is wet, it's like, what is going on? And then when your hair is dry, it's like, who is she? And please let her back into my house. 613 blonde hair, in addition to blonde hair in general from dark colors, tends to go through a lot of chemical processes to get to that color. So what I like to do when I get this kind of unit is I like to give the hair just a little bit of a trim to get rid of any dead ends or anything that might have gotten damaged in the coloring process, just so I can start with a nice fresh and layered cut, and then I go in and cut more as needed once I see the unit on my head and see, you know, what needs to be shaped for my face personally. But this is kind of what the unit's looking like after just being freshly blow dried. Now this is what it's looking like on my head, and you might be like, Bree, what's up with the blue? But I think I just wanted to try this out and do something different. So right now I'm just going in and cutting the lace in threes. Ignore how far I cut one of the strips over. Like, I didn't do it in the perfect center, but it is fine. Look, we are operation make it work. It's fine. And it came out great. So I'm using the Erica J glue. I'm going to definitely do a full video just about, you know, her line for wig installs, because it's the truth. I mean, spoiler alert, but I am so obsessed with this glue. Everything feels so secure. I love it. So I'm just going in with that and then patting that down. I put on her skin guard before that because they work really well together. And now that the glue has gotten tacky, I'm taking out one of the clips and I'm just going to lay down that front piece. I look through the lace to make sure that it's lined up and ahead of my natural hairline just a pinch. And see, I'm very careful. Like, I don't put the lace into the glue until I know for a fact that it's in the right spot. And then you always want to work from the center outward when you're pressing that lace down, because that is a really, really important part so you don't get any of those weird little ripples or anything like that. Then I'm taking one of my favorite carbon combs and I'm just going to use that fine tooth side and push that hairline right down in that lace into my adhesive so that everything is nicely laid. And once your center gets laid well, you know that you're on the right track, okay? I'm gonna get back to cutting the lace in just a second, but I wanted to introduce the Dyson Corral flat iron. This flat iron has flex manganese copper alloy plates, and this is great because it keeps your hair from slipping and sliding out of the plates when you're doing your hair, which is kind of frustrating with other flat irons. The Corral's intelligent heat control regulates the temperature of the plates 100 times per second, which ensures that your flat iron never goes over the heat that you set it to. In times like these, we are trying to conserve energy, but we're also trying not to burn ourselves by accidentally leaving our flat iron on, so auto shut off is a key component for me. Now, I don't know about y'all, but one of my least favorite things about flat irons and heat tools is looking for a place on my counter to just lay them down without burning the counter or a shirt or a t-shirt, whatever you use to put your hot tools comes on. So I love that the Dyson Crowd comes with a charging magnetic docking station. So you can also charge your wireless flat iron while you are actually in the middle of your styling session. Y'all, I see in so many tutorials, people be getting so mad when the person doesn't show cutting off the lace. So I'm here to show y'all, and you might see one tiny ripple, but that's literally just where that cut is. So that's gonna get fixed in the styling process and everything. But I'm just using cuticle scissors. You can use whatever you want. I know some people use brow razors. If you see me getting a little red, it's just because, you know, I get red. Y'all OGs will know this is a regular thing. So now I'm just separating out some strands for baby hair. Since this unit is so light, I try not to go overboard with baby hair when I'm doing a unit that's so colorful. So I like to just do my baby hairs with a little preliminary cut. It's not the final cut that I'm gonna do, but it's just to identify what is gonna be baby hair versus what isn't. And I can do a whole separate video on this because wig baby hairs is a whole other art form, ball game, you know what I'm saying? So I definitely can do that. And then this is what the baby hairs look like all laid down. Keep in mind, this unit is still in its blow dried state. So I was trying to decide, but I definitely want to do some flat iron curls today. Plus, I feel like flat iron curls is something that people overlook oftentimes. So a lot of people are very quick to reach for a curling iron, but it is possible to achieve these styles with just one tool. Dyson also noted and claims that their flat iron causes about 50% less damage and breakage than the traditional flat iron because of these flexible copper alloy plates and the fact that it's cord free. The plates gather your hair and your hair is less likely to slip out. So they claim that it causes 50% less breakage, less frizz, and less flyaways. So I'm going to be using it for now on the 365 degree setting just because this wig is already pretty straight naturally as opposed to my real hair where I might use the hotter setting. Now let's get into the tea on how to do a perfect flat iron curl. So you're going to rotate the flat iron about 180 degrees until the back plates are facing the front. Then you're going to gently slide and turn another 45 degrees, as you can see. And you're gonna hold the back end of the hair to guide, and you're gonna slide that flat iron all the way to the very end. And as you can see, I slowed this down, but look at how that hair is staying in those flex plates. A lot of times you would see your hair slip out of a traditional flat iron, but look at that curl, y'all. Between the copper plates and the round body of this flat iron, you do get that perfect curl. I noticed that the shape of the actual outside of the corral really does help with creating that barrel curl because while the hair is still hot, it is forming to the barrel outside of the flat iron. I want y'all to see how close I'm getting to my face because they also design these plates where they don't actually like touch your skin when you get really close to the roots of your hair, which is so great, y'all. Now I'm gonna skip a little closer to the front of my head as we are almost finished, but there's a specific part I wanted y'all to see because I am so excited. Y'all really gonna see that cotton candy look when I get to the very front two pieces. You might wonder why I clipped them separately, but this is why. Look at the dimensions, okay? Miss Hand Dye really did something here, might have, but see, look at that curl. So I wanted the blue pieces in the front to stand out. We are on the last piece, y'all. That's the best feeling. Every time you do your hair, and look, quick curl cam right here, y'all. Boop. All right, so now I'm just gonna actually brush some of the curls out. Also, rookie mistake, but I used Vaseline on the lace to prevent staining, and I don't think I'm gonna do that again because I thought I got all of it out, but a little bit was still there, and so it made the hair a little bit oily, but I'm gonna hit it with some dry shampoo later on, and these are my final results, y'all. Comment below if you like this hair color, what hair color you'd like to see next, if you wanna see more wig videos. I love y'all. Thank you to Dyson for sponsoring this video, and I will see you in the next one.